Can you tell us why you are here?
When we first arrived, we could hear your voice. We listened to it, we recorded it, and then listened to it, and we could hear you talking to us.
Something moved in this corner.
Why is the door moving? I'm not doing it.
Someone that's got something to say.
I can hear that from here, Jeff. I can hear it through the headphones.
Who's walking? Someone's walking.
I saw a shadow.
Residence is located in Raynham, Kent, and over several years paranormal activity has been reported. All of the children that stay in this house have seen a man in a cap that stands on their upstairs hallway. Before the houses were built in this area, an army barracks occupied this location. When the army base closed its doors in around 1950, it was used for families awaiting housing who had nowhere else to go. So who could the man in the cap be that the children are seeing? Is it an army man from the former barracks? Or could it be the former occupants, Frank and Esme Smith, who have now passed away? All we know is that the children are scared, and we need to find out that whatever is here will not cause them any harm.
Okay, so since the day that you've moved here, your children have always spoke about a man that wears a hat that wanders the house?
Yeah. Robert, first of all, when we first moved in, he started having bad dreams. And we figured it was just the change of house and what have you. And he would be the one that would say about the man with the hat. So it was only really Robert to start off with. And then it wasn't until Michael was between 2 and 3. So Robert had stopped having those bad dreams. Robert wasn't seeing the man in the hat, wasn't scared of the man in the hat. But then Michael, when he was about 2 or 3, started being scared of the man with the hat. Or the man on the stairs, Michael was the man on the stairs. And then we had that for a little while with Michael, and then it had stopped, and then Caitlin then had it again. She was, she hadn't started school, so I've narrowed it down to between the ages of 2 and 3 and a half.
So your niece came over here to stay?
Yeah, I used to look after her when she was about 6 months old as a baby. She was here a couple of days in the week.
So she didn't know anything about a man in the hat?
No.
Your children have seen the man in the hat?
Yep.
She comes over and stays in the house, and then after she stays here, she then mentions to you, who's the man in the hat, or I've seen the man in the hat?
Well, she wouldn't go out into the corridor, so she'd been playing with Caitlin, and she wouldn't go out because she said there was a man, and she was quite hysterically upset that she wouldn't go out there. I think whereas my kids, they would be quite hysterical the first couple of times, but then after that I'd be saying there's nothing there, don't worry about it, there's nothing there, carry on playing. Mia, sort of where she hadn't had that, she was quite hysterical and wouldn't go out and were quite upset. Even when her mum turned up, she told her mum that there was a man in the hat at the door, and she didn't like him. You know, they have had nightmares, and obviously just the literally frozen that they can't walk out into the corridor. Caitlin in bed will just be, she won't even get out of bed. So, because there's two places, which is by the like front door and like the stairs, and then just outside their bedroom. So she'll be laying in bed, and it's where she's looking out. It's on like the landing, which again is what Robert says, that he used to see him on the landing.
So you're saying the man with the hat, stands here?
Yeah.
Which way is he facing? Like that or like that?
Caitlin, can you remember?
But he's standing here. But is he looking forward or is he?
I can't remember. All I know is he stood there.
He stands here?
Yeah.
Caitlin, where did you used to see that man? You know that man that used to scare you? Where did you see him? Where did he stand?
Do you remember?
At the front door.
At the front door. Can you remember him being up here? Whereabouts did he stand up here?
There.
What, where that man is now?
Is this where he used to stand? Here? Yeah? Okay. Can we speak to the man who wears the hat? Can you come and speak to us, please? Can you tell us what your name is? Can you tell us why you are here? Did you used to live here in this house? Are you connected to the children? Why do you stand up on the landing? I actually thought I heard something then.
Carry on.
Can't be sure.
Thank you.
here 8 years.
I can hear that from here, Jeff. I can hear it through the headphones. Do it again. Take it out. You don't need to.
Been here 8 years.
Our EVP live session had proved fruitful. We had captured a man's voice responding to my questions. Here's the enhanced audio taken from the digital recorder. Can you tell us why you are here? Can you tell us why you are here? Are you connected to the children? Are you connected to the children? Why do you stand up on the landing? I actually thought I heard something then. Why do you stand up on the landing? I actually thought I heard something then. With our static night cams set up and recording, it was time for our investigation. Can you hear my voice? Is there someone here with us that can speak to us now? Someone that's got something to say? We picked up your voice earlier. Within minutes of commencing our investigation, another EVP is captured, saying, "Who's that there again?" Here's the enhanced audio.
Someone that's got something to say. We picked up your voice earlier. Someone that's got something to say. We picked up your voice earlier.
Do something to let us know that you're here. I don't know what it is, but I'm hearing something out there.
Yeah.
Have you heard anything out there, Phil?
Yeah, it's like a clicky, knocky noise, but I'm not sure.
Okay, let's come out here.
Difficult to, with this chair.
We spoke to you earlier. You said that you've been here for ages. Are you trapped here? Are you stuck here? Are you unhappy being here?
Coming from upstairs.
What's that for?
Noise coming from upstairs.
I don't know where it come from.
Sounded like it was upstairs.
I can hear the central heating.
Yeah, you can hear the pipes clicking, but that's consistent. But that was another, a different noise. Could you come down the stairs again, like you did before, and come and talk to us, please?
What's your name?
You see a shadow then?
Something just went right across the top of the stairs.
Yeah.
Very quickly, but I saw it. Did you see it?
I did, yeah.
There was a woman there.
Yeah, it was a dark shadow moved across the top of the stairs.
What's your name? Are you Frank? What was the lady's name? Esme.
Esme.
Yeah.
Esme? Is it you that's here? Frank? Esme? Who's the man that wears the cap that stands here in the hallway? Jesus! Just went through me. I've just got something go through me.
I was saying to Peter about static on my arms.
Now this wasn't the usual stuff. It was more of a sharp. Who is it? What's your name?
I just saw a shadow. Flashed.
Was it next to me, Pete? Because I'm feeling.
By your arm, yeah.
Yeah, I'm feeling it. We all see a shadow figure move very quickly. Where I am standing, as static goes through my body, and also static goes through Phil, who is standing at the bottom of the stairs. Here's the footage again, slowed down, so the shadow figure can be seen. Do you mean to scare the children?
Or are you looking after them, looking out for them? Perhaps you're a relative from the past that's keeping an eye on your great-grandchildren or something like that?
Before
This house was here. There was an army base. Are you anything to do with the army? That's why you wear a hat. Are you part, or was you part, of the army base that was here, that got closed down, and then it was used as a place for families to come until they could find housing for them? And they used to stay here, sleep here, eat, schooling. Are you any one of those people? Why do you stand here? Getting static again, going through both arms.
I've
now.
I've got it as well, Jeff.
Have you got that as well?
Yeah, I've got static in both my arms.
It's going through me now, right up through my legs. Through my legs, through my jeans, going up through my arms.
Detecting anything, but I've been getting it as well.
No, this is quite powerful now. It's just as strong as it was before. Oh dear. The hairs are all standing up all over me. Who are you? What's your name? Was weird.
Felt something on your back, did you?
Yeah, like someone touching my t-shirt.
It's getting static going through me.
You got static again?
Yeah. Feel my hairs on my arm.
I can feel
the static.
Whoa. I'm feeling it. I've got it again now.
Yeah.
So it's confirmation. Yep, I can feel it. It's coming over to me now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's not on me now.
It's on me.
Can I put the UV light on it to see?
If you want to, it's going through me really. There it goes.
Yeah, all your hairs are standing up. Weird.
What's the matter then?
A tug on my t-shirt.
You did?
Yeah. Just around the back there.
And
only a little bit.
And I just got touched with my back to Caitlin's room.
Yeah.
And you've just been tugged as well.
It was just literally just a tiny little tug.
We don't want you to hide from us. We know that you're here. We've seen you already. We've heard you already. Is there anything we can do to help you? And on the side of my face.
Yeah, okay.
Through my arms.
Can you come and talk to us, please? Movement that corner. Something moved in this corner.
Why is the door moving? I'm not doing it.
I hear movement, walking, coming from the other side of the room, followed by the door starting to close by itself. Movement that corner. Something moved in this corner.
Why is the door moving? I'm not doing it.
Do you mind us being here? When we first arrived, we could hear your voice. We listened to it, we recorded it, and then listened to it, and we could hear you talking to us. So we know you can talk to us. We've also felt you. You tugged on my t-shirt. And did this static on our arms, we can feel that. But in the past, apparently you've shown yourself. You've stood roughly where I'm standing now. And you've been seen. That'd be nice to know, firstly, who you are. And secondly, why you stay here. Whether you're happy here, which is probably the most likely thing.
Can you use the device that's in the middle of the table? Use the white noise and come through and speak to us. What's your name?
That's good. That's good.
Say that again. What is your name? Eddie, why are you here? Can you tell us why you're here? Yes. Tell us why you're here, please. Eddie, is it you that's got the hat on that's upstairs? Who's Ed? Another voice come through said, who's Ed? Are you the man with the hat on? Yes or no? I think that said, I don't know. Come on, Eddie, don't leave us. Come back through. Is the man with the hat still here? Does he still stay in this house?
Yes.
He is. Yeah.
He is. The man in the hat. What's his name? Why is it you show yourself to the children and not to us?
No. No. It's okay.
What do you need help for? What help do you need? Who's walking? Someone's walking. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Someone's walking. As we all sit together in the dining area, I hear footsteps coming from above us, and it is captured on the digital recorder that I am holding. Here's the enhanced audio. Who's walking? Someone's walking. Who's walking? Someone's walking. I'll make a deal with you. You stop scaring the kids. Okay, don't show them. There was just another noise upstairs. Stop scaring the kids. Don't show yourself to them. Okay? And then you can stay here. But if you keep on scaring the kids, then you'll have to leave. Is that a deal? So do we have an understanding? Just stay away from the children. And leave them alone. Otherwise you will have to leave. Is there anything that you want to say before we leave? A man's voice is captured on my digital recorder saying the word children. Here's the audio enhanced.
Is there anything that you want to say before we leave? Is there anything that you want to say before we leave?
We concluded our investigation at the Cowdery residence. Whoever the spirits are here, possibly Frank Smith, Esme Smith, maybe Eddie the man in the cap from the old army camp that once stood on this site. They are here watching over the children, and they do not mean any harm. I am still in contact with Lorraine Cowdery, and all is quiet now inside the house. Thank you.
and on the side of my face.
Yeah, okay.
Through my arms. Can you come and talk to us, please? Movement that corner. Something moved in this corner.
Why is the door moving? I'm not doing it.
I hear movement, walking, coming from the other side of the room, followed by the door starting to close by itself.
Movement in that corner. Something moved in this corner.
Why is the door moving?
I'm not doing it.
Do you mind us being here? When we first arrived, we could hear your voice. We listened to it, we recorded it and then listened to it and we could hear you talking to us. So we know you can talk to us. We've also felt you. You tugged on my t-shirt. And the static on our arms, we can feel that. But in the past, apparently you've shown yourself. You've stood roughly where I'm standing now. And you've been seen. That'd be nice to know, firstly, who you are.
Who's walking? Someone's walking.
I saw a shadow.
Residence is located in Raynham, Kent, and over several years paranormal activity has been reported. All of the children that stay in this house have seen a man in a cap that stands on their upstairs hallway. Before the houses were built in this area, an army barracks occupied this location. When the army base closed its doors in around 1950, it was used for families awaiting housing who had nowhere else to go. So who could the man in the cap be that the children are seeing? Is it an army man from the former barracks? Or could it be the former occupants, Frank and Esme Smith, who have now passed away? All we know is that the children are scared, and we need to find out that whatever is here will not cause them any harm.
Okay, so since the day that you've moved here, your children have always spoke about a man that wears a hat that wanders the house?
Yeah. Robert, first of all, when we first moved in, he started having bad dreams, and we figured it was just the change of house and what have you. And he would be the one that would say about the man with the hat. So it was only really Robert to start off with, and then it wasn't until Mike walked out into the corridor. Caitlin in bed will just be, she won't even get out of bed. So, because there's two places, which is by the like front door and like the stairs, and then just outside their bedroom. So she'll be laying in bed, and it's where she's looking out. It's on like the landing, which again is what Robert says, that he used to see him on the landing.
So you're saying the man with the hat,
yeah,
stands here?
Yeah.
Which way is he facing? Like that or like that?
Caitlin, can you remember?
But he's standing here. But is he looking forward or is he...
I can't remember. All I know is he stood there.
He stands here?
Yeah.
Caitlin, where did you used to see that man? You know that man that used to scare you? Where did you see him? Where did he stand?
Do you remember?
At the front door.
At the front door. Can you remember him being up here? Whereabouts did he stand up here?
There.
What, where that man is now?
Is this where he used to stand? Here? Yeah? Okay. Can we speak to the man who wears the hat? Can you come and speak to us, please? Can you tell us what your name is? Can you tell us why you are here? Do you mean to scare the children?
Or are you looking after them, looking out for them? Perhaps you're a relative from the past that's keeping an eye on your great-grandchildren or something like that?
Before this house was here, there was an army base. Are you anything to do with the army? That's why you wear a hat.
Are you part, or was you part, of the army base that was here? That got closed down? And then it was used as a place for families to come until they could find housing for them. And they used to stay here, sleep here, eat, schooling. Are you any one of those people? Why do you stand here? Getting static again, going through both arms now.
I've got it as well, Jeff.
Have you got that as well?
Yeah, I've got static in both my arms.
It's going through me now, right up through my legs. Through my legs, through my jeans, going up through my arms.
Detecting anything, but I've been getting it as well.
No, this is quite powerful now. It's just as strong as it was before. Oh dear. The hairs are all standing up all over me. Who are you? What's your name? Are you connected to the children? Why do you stand up on the landing? I actually thought I heard something then. Why do you stand up on the landing? I actually thought I heard something then. With our static night cams set up and recording, it was time for our investigation. Can you hear my voice? Is there someone here with us that can speak to us now? Someone that's got something to say? We picked up your voice earlier.
Within minutes of commencing our investigation, another EVP is captured, saying, "Who's that there again?" Here's the enhanced audio.
Someone that's got something to say. We picked up your voice earlier. Someone that's got something to say. We picked up your voice earlier. Do something to let us know that you're here.
Apparently you've shown yourself. You've stood roughly where I'm standing now. And you've been seen. That'd be nice to know firstly, who you are, and secondly, why you stay here, whether you're happy here, which is probably the most likely thing.
Can you use the device that's in the middle of the table? Use the white noise and come through and speak to us. What's your name?
It's good. It's good.
Say that again. What is your name? Eddie, why are you here? Can you tell us why you're here? Yes. Tell us why you're here, please. Eddie, is it you that's got the hat on that's upstairs? Who's Ed? Another voice come through said, who's Ed? Are you the man with the hat on? Yes or no? I think that said, I don't know. Come on, Eddie, don't leave us. Come back through. Is the man with the hat still here? Does he still stay in this house?
Yes.
He is there.
He is. The man in the hat, what's his name? Why is it you show yourself to the children and not to us? Why do you stand here? Getting static again, going through both arms
now. I've got it as well, Jeff.
Have you got that as well?
Yeah, I've got static in both my arms.
It's going through me now, right up through my legs. Through my legs, through my jeans, going up through my arms.
It's not detecting anything, but I've been getting it as well.
No, this is quite powerful now. It's just as strong as it was before. Hairs are all standing up all over me. Who are you? What's your name? That was weird.
Felt something on your back, did you?
Yeah, like someone touching my t-shirt.
It's getting static going through me.
You got static again?
Yeah. Feel my hairs on my arm.
I can feel it.
Feel the static.
I'm feeling it. I've got it again now.
Yeah.
So it's confirmation. Yep, I can feel it. It's coming over to me now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's not on me now.
It's on me.
Can I put the UV light on it to see?
If you want to, it's going through me really. There it goes.
Yeah, all your hairs are standing up.
weird.
What's the matter then?
A tug on my t-shirt.
You did?
Yeah. Just around the back there.
And
only a little bit.
And I just got touched with my back to Caitlin's room.
Yeah.
And you've just been tugged as well.
It was just literally just a tiny little tug.
Otherwise, you will have to leave. Is there anything that you want to say before we leave?
A man's voice is captured on my digital recorder saying the word, children. Here's the audio enhanced.
Is there anything that you want to say before we leave? Is there anything that you want to say before we leave?
Concluded our investigation at the Cowdery residence. Whoever the spirits are here, possibly Frank Smith, Esme Smith, maybe Eddie, the man in the cap from the old army camp that once stood on this site. They are here watching over the children, and they do not mean any harm. I am still in contact with Lorraine Cowdery, and all is quiet now inside the house.